the red subscribe button right under the video and also the bell icon to get notification on any of our latest updates on the videos.
Hello everyone, welcome to our new video. In this video we are going to solve a question on dye leveling. The question says, the following observations made by a tachometer with an analytic lens, the multiplying constant being 100. So from the question we know our multiplier constant m is equal to 100, and it says the staff was held vertical. So the staff was held vertical, and since the tachometer has an analytic lens, we know our additive constant is equal to 0, as stated in our previous video. So from this information here, we can draw a schematic diagram. Here we have a negative angle which shows a deviation from our instrument position to this point P, and here we have positive, so it's an elevation, and here we have our bottom reading, middle and top reading similarly here, and height of instrument is constant 1.5. so maybe the terrain for the surface is something like this one. Here we have instrument station as SP, something of this nature. We have something like this. This is our horizontal line of sight. So from here we have our benchmark. In our previous video we know the benchmark is just a fixed point of a non-reduced level, and here from our question the reduced level of the benchmark is 460.500 meter, the reduced level of this benchmark. So here we have our star position 1. Here also we have our star position, and this one is point Q from the question, point Q. And from our instrument we normally have three readings, the first one being our top reading. So our top reading is given as 4.2, 1.860, and our middle reading is given as 1.340 here, and then our bottom reading is given as 0.820. At the angle 7.5, our theta we know is the angle between middle line and the horizontal line of sight. So between the middle line and the horizontal line of sight, here we have our theta, which is called 7 degree 5 minutes. So similarly here we also have our readings. This is our horizontal line of sight. We have our readings, the deviation angle here. So here we have our tough reading as 2.065. We have our middle reading as 1.515. And lastly, we have our bottom reading, which is 0.965. And so the angle here is the angle between this horizontal line of sight and our middle reading. Is given as 6 degree 12 minutes. As you can see, it's a deviation. That's why we have this negative sign here, and this one is an elevation from our horizontal line of sight. We have positive value there. If we extend this one, we know the vertical distance between our middle reading to the horizontal line of sight is our V. Let's call this as section 1, let's say section 1 and 2. Here we have our V1, and the distance from this reduced level of this benchmark, the vertical distance between this benchmark and the middle reading is our elevation, which is over the reduced level of point, this point, let's call it H1. here also, the horizontal, the middle gradient, the distance between the middle gradient and this horizontal line, horizontal line of sight is our V2, and if here is our surface, so if here is our surface, here the distance between the middle line to the surface is our H2, our elevation at that point D. Point 2, section point 22, and the horizontal distance between Q and Q is our D. Also here we have another D, let's call this D2, and the horizontal distance between this point 1 to our instrument position is our D1. So from the question, it says that, it says find the horizontal distance PQ, that means we have to find this D2 here, since it says PQ from instrument position to this point Q. So we have to find our D2, and this D2 is giving us MS2, our stop gradient at point 2, cos square theta plus C cos theta, but since it is an analytic lens, we know our additive constant is 0, and our stop gradient at point 2 is given as what? Top gradient minus the bottom gradient is equal to 1.860 minus 0.820. So therefore, our stop gradient at point 2 is equal to 1.040 meters. So therefore our distance D2, which is equal to our distance PQ, is equal to our M from the question, multiplying constant is 100 times our stop gradient at point 2 is 1.040 times cos, our theta here is 7 degrees per minute. So if you convert this 7 degrees per minute degree, it will be 7.08 degrees. So we have square or square theta. The final answer, our distance D2, which is equal to PQ, is equal to 102.42 meters. This is our horizontal distance between point our instrument position P and stop position Q. Now B part of the question says we have to find the reduced level of Q. So reduced level of Q. The reduced level of Q is equal to the reduced level of our benchmark here plus H1 plus B1 plus H1 plus B1 plus B2 minus H2. So this will give us our reduced level of this point Q. Of this point, the reduced level of this point is the reduced level of this point A plus H1 plus V1 plus B2 minus H2. That means from here to the datum is our reduced level of Q. To the datum, here we have our datum, which is the same as that of this benchmark. The datum is the same thing. So here the reduced level of this benchmark to the datum also plus our H1 here plus B1 here here plus B2 minus H2 will give us the distance from here from the surface to our datum, which is the reduced level point Q. So this level of benchmark is already given from the question, But H1, V1, V2 and H2, we have to find them. We know that our H1 from here, from the surface where the stuff is held, was held to the, our middle reading is our H1, similarly for H2. So therefore we can say that our H1 is the same thing as our middle reading, which is giving us 1.515, and our H2 same thing as our middle reading, 4.2, which is giving us 1.340, and our V1, given by the formula MS1 sine 2 theta all over 2 plus C sine theta, but our C is 0 since we are using an analytic lens. So our S1 is same thing as our tough reading at 0.1 minus bottom reading at 0.1, which is equal to 2.065 minus 0.965, which is equal to 1.100. So therefore our B1 is equal to 100 times 1.100 times 1.100 times sine 2 into theta 1. Our theta 1 is giving us 6 degrees 12 minutes. So if you convert that into degrees, you'll have, if you convert this, that you'll get 6.2 degrees here over 2. So therefore B1 is equal to, V1 will be 11.81 meter. Then our V2 is equal to M, stop reading at 0.2, sine 2 theta 2 all over 2 plus C sine theta, also here our C is 0. So here our B2 is equal to, our M is given as 100 times our staff reading 1.040 times sine 2 into 7.08 degrees over 2. So if you press this in your calculator, the vertical distance V2 will be, it will be 12.72 meters. Now since we have all the parameters, we can calculate the reduced level of Q, or point Q, which is equal to, say, the reduced level of our benchmark 460.500 plus our H1. Our H1 is 1.515 plus our V1 11.81 plus our V2 12.72 minus our H2, which is 1.340 here. So our reduced level will be, the reduced level is going to be 485.205 meters. This is our reduced level of point Q. So thank you for watching. If you have any query, you can forward it to our comment section.